Hey guys, welcome to this tutorial on electrical protection, which is undoubtedly one of the most important part of an electrical engineer's job. Because when you have an installation, an electrical network, substation, transmission line, and all of that sort, you have to ensure that the system does not fail. In case of a short circuit, something go wrong, a component failure, you don't want your entire network to go down because of a 140 component. So based on that, you have to know your short circuit current on every stages of your network. That way you will be able to provide adequate protection based on the short circuit level. So the diagram we have in front of us is a network diagram that is made of a generator, a transformer, a line impedance, a transformer 2, and the load connected. Now, we're going to do a tutorial on per unit. Per unit is a percentage unit of a way of representing an equivalent of an electrical component in an impedance form. For instance, a generator, an entire generator can be modeled to a per unit value. Transformer, the line, and so forth. That way, using your base values and your line impedance or your component impedance, you will be able to calculate your short circuit current or MVA. That is how you determine the level of the fault on any particular part of your circuit. For example, if you have a short circuit in this point here, you got a short circuit to ground at this point, that means the entire power that is being supplied from the generator to this transformer, the next one, is going to flow from this point into the ground. How you going to know the magnitude of that short circuit current is by knowing the overall line impedance value. This is why it is important to have an impedance diagram in a per unit form. That's helping calculating and getting into that point. So this is the purpose of this tutorial. So without wasting any further time, let's get going. Okay. The first thing to do here first is to work per zone. We have zone 1 already, I've shown already on the schematic here, zone 1, zone 2, and zone 3. Why do we divide it by per zone? We divide it per zone so that we don't make mistakes. Then zone 3, which is fed by a second transformer T2, which have a ratio of 1000 to 500 volt. But make no mistake here that your secondary voltage here will be 500 volt. No. Because this transformer primary voltage of 1000 is not the same as this transformer here, secondary voltage of 800 volt. So you have to do a transformer calculation of the secondary voltage based on that. So there's a formula that you do that. So that's basically how you focus per zones in order to limit your mistakes. So, and we will note also, we've given the per unit voltage, the old per unit for each component. So the generator got an old per unit of 0.2, the transformer 0.1, and so forth. So The general formula of per unit calculation is based on using the old values so that we can work on a new value, because a new value will be worked based on the new volt ampere value that is given. This is why you change from the old to the new, because you are working on a different base now. Okay, so let's see what we can do here. So solving for zone 1, what do we have for zone 1? We got a 250 volt and a 5 kVA generator. Now, since we are looking for the new per unit value for the generator, there is a general formula that we spoke about that is used to calculate the per unit of an electrical element on the network, which is given by the following formula. The Z per unit new that we calculating is equal to the Z per unit old. In this case, for the generator, it's going to be the 0.2 per unit times SBN, which is SB new. So that's the apparent power. VA new, that is given here for our network as a base voltage. So I mean the base MVA, 5 kVA, and SBO or SB old, which is the old volt ampere of the element that we calculating. In this case, a generator said it's got a 5 kVA base, so which means our SBO will be 5 kVA times the VBO, which is the base voltage of this section, the old one, divided by the VBN, which is the base voltage, the new base voltage of the section, which is also 250 volt in this case, the whole square, as you can see in the formula. So moving on for our zone 1, with the generator, we have VB, which is the base voltage of the generator, 250 volt. SBN, as we said, which is given for the entire system, 5 kVA. And SB old, in this case of the generator, if there was a different than given there, that would be shown here since it's the same. So we nevertheless write it. So that is 5 kVA. Then moving on, we then replace all the values that we have available into the formula and type it in a calculator to get the result. By computing into the calculator, then we find the following result. So the Z per unit new for the generator is equal to 0.2 J per unit. Basically, it's the same thing because the generator have got the same base voltage and it's got the same kVA apparent power as the one given by the exercise. So everything cancel out, we left with the same per unit value as the old one. So this is now the result that we get. So moving on into the transformer to calculate the new per unit value of the transformer. We note that we are still working on zone 1. So which means our base voltage is still 250 volt with the same kVA as given. Now the transformer T1 have an old volt ampere apparent power of 4 kVA. And it's also got a 250-800 volt voltage ratio. But as we're working from zone 1, so we consider the primary voltage, which is related to the generator voltage feeding in, so which is our base voltage in this case. So in this case, we then look at the values that we have for the transformer. So what do we have? The base value remained the same as 250 volt. The SBN, which is the new base VA in this case, is still 5 kVA, as when it is given, we use that for the entire system. Now SBO, which is the old volt ampere value, We note that the transformer got a new one, 4 kVA. That's what we have here. Then we use the same base formula to plot in the value. Plotting in the values into the calculator, we have the following result. So we got the Z per unit all of the transformer, which is 0.1. The new kVA divided by the old times the base voltage old divided by the base voltage new, which is the same as you can see. The old one and the new one coming from the generator is still the same. So it is cancelled. Then we only have those to compute with those values. So we got the result of 0.125 J per unit. So the answer for our transformer is then J0125 per unit. This is how you compute this per unit operations. We're going to stop this video here before it gets too long. So we're going to continue on part one of the video for the line per unit of the line here, as you can see, and transformer 2 and the per unit of the load. At the end, we should be able to draw an impedance diagram based on the different per unit. So tune in for part 2 of the video to see how we're going to solve this problem. Thank you. And please, if you find any useful information in this tutorial, please like, share, and subscribe to keep up to date for tutorial like this. Thank you.